Kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
My life, my life, my life, my life. pray thou against my name on. There is no healing in my flesh in the face of thy wrath, and there is no peace in my bones in the face of my sins. My iniquities are risen high with my head, as a heavy burden that it pressed every month. My bruises are become noise and corrupt in the face of my fall. I have been wretched and only bowed down to the end. All the day long I went without fast face. My loins are filled with longing, and there is no healing in my flesh. I am afflicted and humbled exceedingly. I have roared and drunk at my heart, the Lord before thee is all my desire. My groaning is not hid from thee. My heart is troubled, my strength is failing. The light of mine eyes, even this, is not with me. My friends and my neighbors draw nigh over against me and stood. The mighty nearest of kin stood afar off. And they that sought after my soul used violence. And they that saw evil for me spoke great things. For after this all day long they meditate. But as for me, like a dead man, I heard his voice. And as a specious man, it opened not his mouth. And I became as a man that feareth God, that hath the blood of the rules. For in thee have I hope the Lord. Thou wilt hearken unto me, O Lord my God, for I said, let them my enemies rejoice over me. Yea, but my feet were shaken, and men spake boastful words against me. For I am ready for scourges, and my sorrows continually for me. I will declare my iniquity, and I will take heed concerning my sin. But my enemies have lived and remained strong enough. They that hate me unjustly are multiplied. They that render me evil for good surrender me because I pursue goodness. Forsake me not, O Lord, my God, depart not from me. Be attentive unto my help, O Lord, my God. Be attentive unto my help, O Lord, of my salvation. Forsake me not, O Lord, my God. Depart not from me. Be attentive unto my help, O Lord, of my salvation. O God, my God, thee I rise early at dawn. My soul hath thirsted for thee. Often have my flesh long after thee in the land of air and of charm and of water. In the sanctuary I have appeared before thee to see thy power and thy glory. For thy mercy is better than lives. My lips shall praise thee. So shall I bless thee, my love. And in thy name will I lift up my hands, as with prayer and gladness let my soul be filled. And with lips of rejoicing shall my mouth praise thee. If I remember thee in my bed, at the dawn I meditate on thee. Thou art become my comfort and shelter, and thy wings will I rejoice. My soul hath believed after thee, thy right hand hath been quick to help me. But as for thee, these in vain have they sought after my soul. They shall go down to the nethermost parts of the earth. They shall be surrounded with peace unto the end of the soul. Portions for foxes shall they eat. But the king shall be glad in God, everyone shall be praised and swear in my hand. For the mouth of them is stopped and speak unjust things. At the dawn I meditate on thee, thou art become my comfort. To the shelter of thy wings will I rejoice. My soul hath been after thee, and thy right hand hath been quick to help me. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Now and ever and unto ages of ages, Lord. O God of my salvation, by day, by cloud, by night before thee, let my prayers before thee bow down thine ear unto my supplication. For filled with evils is my soul, and my life and hate is left on thine. I am come to the depth, and have never down into the depth. I have become as a man without hope, in among the dead, like the sun that rises and slain and sleep in the grave, whom thou remembers no more in their cup from thy hand. They lay me below us in the darkness and the shadow of death. Against me is thine anger raised, strong in all thy filthiness that thou brought upon me. Thou hast removed my friends apart from me, they have made me abomination unto themselves. I have been delivered and have not come forth. Mine eyes have grown weak from poverty. I have cried unto the Lord, O Lord. I have cried unto thee, O Lord. The whole day long I have stretched out my hands unto thee. Nay, the dead hath thou worked wonders. For shall physicians raise them up that they may sing, give thanks unto thee. Nay, shall they be the grave to tell of thy mercy, and of thy truth and thy destruction. Nay, shall thy wonders be known in thy darkness, and thy righteousness in the land is forgotten. But as for me unto thee, O Lord, have I cried in the morning, shall my prayer come before thee. Wherever, O Lord, hast thou cast off my soul, and turnest thy face away from me. A poor man am I, and in the troubles from my youth. Yea, having been exalted, I was humbled and brought to distress. Thy furies have passed upon me, and thy prayers have sorely troubled me. Thou didst move afar from me. Did friend and neighbor mine acquaintance because of my misery. O Lord, thou art my salvation by day of my pride and by night of thee. God left my prayer home for thee. Bow down my ear to my supplication. Bless the Lord of my soul and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord of my soul, forget not all that he hath done from thee, who is gracious upon unto all thy iniquities, who healeth all thine infirmities, who redeemeth thy life from corruption, who crowneth thee with mercy and compassion, who fulfilleth thy desire with good things, thy youth shall be renewed as the eagles. The Lord performs these kinds and executeth judgment for all them that are wronged. He hath made his way from unto Moses, unto the sons of Israel, the things that he hath willed. Compassion merciful is the Lord, long suffering, plenteous mercy. Not unto the end will he end, neither unto the eternity will he be wroth. Not according to our iniquities that he dealt with us, neither according to our sins that he rewarded us. For according to the heights of heaven from the earth, the Lord hath made his mercy to prevail over them that fear him. As far as east from the west, so far as he removed our iniquities from us. Why does our Father have compassion upon his sons? So hath the Lord have compassion upon them that fear him. For he knoweth where of we are made, he has remembered they were dust. As for man, his days are for us, the flower of the field, so shall be blossom forth. For when the wind is passed over, then it shall be gone, and the long will know the place thereof. But the mercy of the Lord is from eternity, even unto eternity upon them that fear him, and his righteousness upon the sons of sons, upon them that keep his testament, and remembrance his commandment to do them. The Lord of heaven hath prepared his throne, and his kingdom rules over all. Bless the Lord, all you saints, mighty strength. Form his word, to give the voice of his words. Bless the Lord, I his house, to minister to his will. Bless the Lord, I his words in every place of his dominion. Bless the Lord, O my soul, in every place of his dominion. Bless the Lord, O my soul. O Lord, hear my prayer, give ear unto my supplication from thy throne. Hearken unto me of thy righteousness, and enter not into judgment with thy servant. For in the sight of no man, let me be justified, for the enemy hath persecuted my soul. Give home to my life now to hear. He has set me in reference to those who belong to God. My spirit within me has become despondent. Within me, my heart is troubled. I remember the days of old. I meditate on all the works that closed on the foundations of thy hands. I should dwell my hands with thee. My soul fixed up thee in the waterless land. Quickly hear me, O Lord, my spirit is come to light. Turn my face away from thee, lest I be left unto them that go down into the pit. Cause me to hear their mercy and the glory. For in thee there I hope. God, we know the Lord of the way wherein I shall go. And I believe I lifted up my soul. Rescue me from my enemies, O Lord, and thee have left for refuge. Keep me to thee, thou wilt thou art my God. Make a spiritual and new blood into practice. Let mercy stay, let aim give, O Lord. Thou shalt strengthen me. In thy righteousness thou shalt bring my soul out of affliction. In thy mercy shall thy enemies destroy my enemies. And thou shalt cut up all them that afflict my soul. For I am thy servant. O Lord, give ear to my soul. O Lord, to the earth was up the king, and to the mountains of thy service. Life and fear to give you the life of a virgin. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Both now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to thee, O God. Our God and our hope, glory to thee.
In peace let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace from above and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, for the good estate of the holy churches of God, and for the union of all men, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house and for those with faith, reverence, and the fear of God enter therein, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our Father, Metropolitan Joseph, for the venerable priesthood, the diaconate in Christ, for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Metropolitan Paul and Archbishop John, and for their quick release from captivity and safe return,
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the President of the United States, for all civil authorities and for armed forces everywhere, especially for Peter, Joshua, Ronnie, Adam, Andrew, Benjamin, Thaddeus, Skyler, and Tristan, let us pray to the Lord. For this city and for every city and land and for the faithful who dwell therein, for healthful seasons, for abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord. For travelers by sea, by land, and by air, for the sick and the suffering, for captives and for their salvation, for those under persecution for the faith, for our deliverance from all tribulation, wrath, danger, necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Calling to remembrance our all holy, immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos, most and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
Unto thee, O Lord, all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Most blessed and glorious, St. Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary. With all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and our whole life unto Christ our God.
Thine is the majesty, and thine is the kingdom, the power and glory of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages. Amen.
Now and ever and unto ages. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy. O thou, our God, rest in the saints, and unto thee we ascribe glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Gospel, let us pray to the Lord God.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Wisdom, stand upright, let us hear the holy gospel.
Peace be to all.
Jesus took with him Peter and James and John, and went up on the mountain to pray. And as he was praying, the appearance of his countenance was altered, and his raiment became dazzling white. And behold, two men talked with him, Moses and Elijah, who appeared in glory and spoke of his departure, which he was to accomplish at Jerusalem. Now Peter and those who were with him were heavy with sleep, and when they wakened, they saw his glory and the two men who stood with them. And as the men were parting from him, Peter said to Jesus, Master, it is well that we are here. Let us make three booths, one for you, and one for Moses, and one for Elijah, not knowing what he said. As he said this, a cloud came and overshadowed them, and they were afraid as they entered the cloud. And a voice came out of the cloud saying, This is my beloved Son, listen to him. And when the voice had spoken, Jesus was found alone, and they kept silence and told no one in those days anything of what they had seen.
Glory to thee, O Lord, glory to thee.
Mercy on thee, O God, wash me thoroughly from my iniquity and cleanse me from my sin. For I know my iniquity
thy people and bless thine inheritance. Bless thy world with mercies and compassions. Exalt the horn of Orthodox Christians and send down upon us thy rich mercies. Through the intercessions of our all-immaculate Lady Theotokos, never Virgin Mary, and by the might of the precious and life-giving cross, by the protection of the honorable bodiless powers of heaven, at the supplications of thy honorable glorious prophet, Porter and Baptist John, of the holy, glorious, all-lovable apostles, Peter and Paul, and of all thy holy apostles, of our fathers among the saints, great hierarchs and ecumenical teachers, Basil the Great, Gregory the Theologian, and John Chrysostom, Athanasius, Cyril and John the Merciful, Patriarchs of Alexandria, Nicholas of Myra, Spirit and Epimethos, Nectarius and Pentapolis, the wonder workers, of our fathers among the saints, Tikhon, Patriarch of Moscow, and Raphael, Bishop of Brooklyn, of the holy, glorious, great martyrs, George the Trophy Bearer, Demetrius the Mirth Streamer, Theodore the Soldier, Theodore the General, and Minas the Wonder Worker, of the higher martyrs, Ignatius, God Bearer, Marlampos, Eleutherios, of the holy, glorious, great women martyrs, Thecla, Barbara, Anastasia, Catherine, Kiriaki, Putini, Marina, Kreskova, and Irene, of the holy, glorious, right, victorious martyrs, of our venerable and God-bearing fathers who shone in the ascetic life, of St. Barnabas, the patron and protector of this holy community, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, and of all thy saints, we beseech thee, O most merciful Lord, hearken to the petitions of the sinners, and make our supplications unto thee. Have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Why he appeared as the king of above the rock. That is why Moses provided up here as his servant. Until then, our Lord manifested his divine power many times to the disciples, but on Mount Tabor, he manifested his divine nature. This vision of his divinity is a hearing of the heavenly witness about him as the Son of God, who has served the disciples in the days of the Lord's passion, to the strengthening of the unwavering faith in him and his final victory.
Unto Christ God be glory and dominion, unto ages of ages. Amen.
Amen. Yeah.
the Theotokos, and the Mother of the Light, let us honor and magnify in song.
ourselves and each other, and our whole life unto Christ our God. For all the powers of heaven praise thee, and unto thee we ascribe glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages, all of the ages.
Yeah.
Amen.
let us pray to the Lord. For the peace from above and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace of the whole world, for the good estate of the holy churches of God, and for the union of all men, let us pray to the Lord. For this holy house and for those who with faith, reverence, and the fear of God entered therein, let us pray to the Lord. For our Father, Metropolitan Joseph, for the venerable priesthood, the diaconate in Christ, for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord. For Metropolitan Paul and Archbishop John, and for their quick release from captivity and safe return, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the President of the United States, for all civil authorities, and for armed forces everywhere, especially for Peter, Joshua, Ronnie, Adam, Benjamin, Andrew, Thaddeus, and Connor, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this city and for every city and land, and for the faithful who dwell therein, for healthful seasons, for abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the
Lord.
For travelers by sea, by land, and by air, for the sick and the suffering, for captives and for their salvation, for those under persecution for the faith, for our deliverance from all tribulation, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy upon us, and protect us, O God, by your grace. Calling to remembrance our all holy, immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
Ourselves and each other
and our whole life unto Christ our God.
Healing thy voice.
glory to the Lord.
Glory. This is my beloved Son,
wisdom attend, let us hear the Holy Gospel.
Peace be to all.
And to thy spirit.
The reading of the Holy Gospel is according to Saint Matthew.
Glory to thee, O Lord. Glory to thee, O Lord.
Let us attend.
At that time, Jesus took with him Peter and James and John his brother, and led them up a high mountain apart. And he was transfigured before them, and his face shone like the sun, and his garments became white as light. And behold, there appeared to them Moses and Elijah talking with him. And Peter said to Jesus, Lord, it is well that we are here. If you wish, I will make three booths here, one for you, and one for Moses, and one for Elijah. He was still speaking when lo, a bright cloud overshadowed them, and a voice from the cloud said, This is my beloved Son, with whom I am well pleased. Listen to him. When the disciples heard this, they fell on their faces and were filled with awe. But Jesus came and touched them, saying, Rise and have no fear. And when they lifted up their eyes, they saw no one but Jesus only. As they were coming down the mountain, Jesus commanded them, Tell no one the vision until the Son of Man is raised from the dead.
Transported into heaven. It's such a beautiful, beautiful parish. And you've been very engaged in a deep part of our mission movement in a very intimate way, as one of our board members is still parish council president, Armin Brown, who is serving on the board and helping us to do the work that we're doing in spreading the gospel around the world. Now, because your parish has been so involved, I wanted to come just here in California for a couple days. I wanted to make sure I came by to say thank you, to report a little bit on what you're doing. And a funny thing happened to me as I was getting ready for a sermon. I looked and I saw, oh no, it's the Transfiguration. So I want to talk about missions. How do you do that? And I forgot something that I often say, is that there is not a single gospel or Sunday that we pass that does not have a focus on the essence of missions. And sure enough, if you look at what we're doing here with the Transfiguration, it exactly ties in. Why would we think sometimes that it doesn't relate to missions and that it would be a stretch? It's because so often we make missions, or we don't make it, it actually is in so many of our parishes around the nation. Doing missions is like dessert, or maybe one of the side dishes of the church. It's not the thing that our church is entrusted to do. And I thought of that in a new way. recently, and I was thinking, look at the ministry. Oh, there. Something just changed. Can you hear me better? I hear you better. Look at the ministry of Jesus Christ and ask, was saving the world something for him that was on the side, secondary to what he was trying to do? Was transforming the world and transfiguring creation, was that something on the side of what he came to do? He really came for something else, and well, this is kind of like a side benefit. Or is that why he came and gave his life? You know, this is the essence of why the Lord came. I came to save the world so that whoever believes in me might have eternal life. That's the reason he came, not dessert. Whereas I, of course, that's what it's about. And that's what's entrusted to the church. So it's not a stretch, or it shouldn't be a stretch. As we look into what we do Sunday after Sunday, it should be right there in the center. And it is in the center. In today's gospel readings and epistle reading, we can see how bringing this message to the world is a part of everything we just heard. It's kind of interesting when you look at the difference between the gospel we heard in Matins. There were two different accounts. One that we heard in the Matins reading, and another one that we heard now in the liturgy. So, Peter, James, and John, they're there on the mountain with Jesus, and beyond seeing Moses and Elijah, the fascinating thing is that Jesus' face starts shining like the sun. His clothes start glowing. And this wonderful, and then they hear the cloud comes and they hear the voice of God confirming who this person is, not just a regular person. And then what was really striking for me is at the end of the Matins Gospel, it says, they left, and after they left, and they had this experience, and they saw this, they told no one. They just kept it to themselves. Wow. I mean, what would you do if you were there? I would have had my camera out, my phone out, I would have taken a picture, it would have been on Facebook. It's like, wow, do you know what I just saw? This is like amazing. But it said they kept it to themselves. And then you come to the gospel, and it makes a little bit more sense, because in the gospel reading, the liturgy, this account, it says, after that happened, Jesus said, don't tell anybody. He told them not to tell anybody until he rose from the dead. So they were under orders not to take pictures and not to send that out on Facebook until he had risen from the dead. And then they had permission to tell everybody. That's better. In the epistle, you see that's then what started to happen. You have Peter who was writing the epistle, and he's saying, shortly I must put off my tent, meaning he was going to leave his body, and it wasn't because he was sick. So under the threat of death, Peter is out there still proclaiming the message that he was told not to tell until after Jesus was raised from the dead. Not casually telling it, but knowing that he was going to die for this. And he's saying, we were there. We were there present at the Transfiguration, is what he was referring to in the epistle. And we will not be negligent to remind you. If you do these things, an entrance will be given to you to the kingdom of heaven. So he just told them the way to follow and said that if you will do this, you will have a way into the kingdom of heaven. So this process of proclaiming the gospel, of telling people, it's central. Jesus came to save the world and then told us at the right time we are to go out and to do that. And some people say, well, you know, that was given to the apostles. He told his disciples to go out to the world. But it's not what we're supposed to do. Every one of us here, and all the people who become Christian. Where is it? When Jesus said to his disciples, love one another, do you think that was only for them? They're supposed to love one another, but that wasn't being said to everybody who would become a part of the family. Or how about the Last Supper? That was a very intimate thing with just his closest circle. And he said, do this in remembrance of me. Was he just telling the 12 to do this in remembrance of me? Or was that being spread to the entire church as when he ascended into heaven and said, go and make disciples of all nations, not to the people who were there, but to this church that we are a part of. We are to go and to make disciples of all nations. Well, as I said, I wanted to thank the parish because you're having a big part in the work that our church is doing to spread our faith around the nations. You contribute, you're one of the largest contributors to missions in the nation. And each month we receive support from you that goes in various directions. One of those directions is to support the missionaries that are in the field on our behalf, my son included, who are out serving around the world, spreading the gospel. As we heard, as we hear in the epistles, how can they believe unless they hear? And how can they hear unless someone preaches? And how can someone go preach unless they are sent? We have to send the people who are going to preach. There are so many out there that do not have access nearby to hear the gospel. The only way they will hear is if somebody is sent to them. There's nobody around them to preach the gospel. And you're helping to send some of the people that we send around the world. We also have the local clergy. We call it SAMP, Support a Mission Priest. What that is a program that's taking care of just about 400 clergy, subsidizing their income so they can be more free to preach the gospel. And these are men who are working hard and strong around the world, doing fantastic things. They put me to shame. I have Father Zechariah and Father Vladimir working in this desert region of Turkana. I say to them, Fathers, we want to come and we want to go evangelize new villages that have never heard of Jesus Christ. And I come in with a group from the seminary and we go to three villages, and sure enough, three villages haven't heard a thing. We just did this again last year. I've never heard. I asked the group there standing in front of me, have you ever heard of Jesus Christ? And a couple people raised their hands. I said, good, tell me about it. They couldn't explain it. They didn't know who he was. Three entire villages that we went to, and these priests are opening the doors. We proclaim the gospel, people get excited, and it's these clergy that we're supporting that go back. I'm now in dialogue with the priests in the Don, Indonesia. Such a difficult place, they can't walk the streets in a clergy attire. I had a bag with me with a cross on it, and I was with the Metropolitan, and he grabbed my bag and turned it around. He says, Father Mark, you can't walk around the city with a target on your hip. You're going to get me killed because I have the cross. In that situation, these men are working day and night and evangelizing and opening parishes. And the last time I'm there, we started discussing, how do we go to new places where we don't have orthodoxy, where orthodoxy isn't present? And I'm getting ready to go back to Indonesia again to go make a journey with them to explore an area that we've identified to move into. And that's in countries where it's not free, where somebody just says, oh, well, that's not cool. It's where you become a target and these people are doing these things. You're helping to support those people. You're also, right now, we picked a project this year. You're helping to build a church in a remote area that's being evangelized in Kenya. And in that Turkana region that I spoke about, your contributions have gone to help establish what we've done. We've baptized over 1,000 people. We've maxed out what the local clergy can do. They have as many parishes and as much as they can do. And now the next challenge is, how do we increase capacity? So
I wanted to make sure that you know that your parish is helping to shine the light of Christ around the world, that I appreciate it, that we appreciate the work that you're doing, and that by your contributions and by participating in missions, you're doing an awful lot and having a great effect around the world. But there's still more to do, and I want to do just a little bit of props here to help get the picture of what's still ahead of us. I'm going to need about four or five people to come on up and help me do this, if you would. I want to spread something out, so you're not going to have to say anything, but just come on up and give me a hand here. A couple people. We'll start with our board president. You can be the lead, right? And your parish council president. A couple other people. Armin, just walk around and like towards the door with this thing. Okay, just don't trip on anybody. I'm going to take it so we don't get it. Grab and go. Grab and fall down so they don't hit anybody around the corner. Good. Grab and go. Kind of bend the corner there. Need one more person. Yes. Keep going. Okay, now this red here is represent. Okay, that's as far as we can go. We really need to go a lot further. But can somebody come hold the end for me? Imagine that that red tape there that you're looking at represents 900 million people. 900 million. 900 million people is the number of people today in the world that have, like that group that we went to in Africa, that have not heard who Jesus Christ is, such they could say, I believe or I don't believe. 900 million. If I really stretched these people out front to back like this, and we just lined the 900 million up, you know how far they'd go? All the way to Florida. And then from Florida at the equator, all the way around the earth back to here again. And then all the way to Florida and all the way around the earth again, and then still into the United States. That's how many people have still not had a chance to say, I believe or I don't believe. We have our work cut out for us. Next, I'm going to hold up a symbolic piece for how many missionaries, relative to all of this, are proclaiming the gospel. Are you ready? Grab the piece. Can you hold that up? There's our missionaries. You know about how far they're going to get? Probably about right here. So, if you look at the situation that's in front of us, you can see this in two ways. And say, well, it's impossible, it's frustrating, I give up. Or we can say, well, every single piece that we're reaching out to is important. Remember, we leave the 99 to save the one sheep. Every soul that we're able to reach is important for God, and we're saving souls. Your parish is a part of making that happen. And we have a lot more to reach out to. And that last thing that I want to say, just put that there, is stay there for one more second. You're doing a great job. Last thing I want to say is another goal that we have, and I'm praying that this parish has been so vibrant that God is going to raise up a person who is trained and able to be on behalf of the parish, one of our missionaries that's out in the world spreading the gospel. I feel it's going to come someday with all of this energy that you have. So you can do whatever you want with that red tape there. Thank you for that. And let me close up. So again, thank you for all that you're doing. Your parish is having an effect. It's an important thing. It's central to our church. It's why Jesus came, and you're doing it. And we thank you for it, and may God help us to do more, because there's an awful lot of people that we still have to reach. God bless you.
save us, have mercy upon us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace and wisdom.
That guarded always by thy light, we may ascribe glory unto thee, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Thank you.
God remembering his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
To the ages of ages.
Amen. All Orthodox Christians, especially Father Mark and his family, the James, Jennifer, Dustin, your Christian, Barry and Ann, for Ivan and Nicola, for Elin and Serena, for Kevin, for Taylor, for Christina, Autumn, for Michelle, Lauren, Laurie, Kelsey, Stephanie, Gabriel, Mary, and Claire. That the Lord our God will remember them in his kingdom, always, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Departed this life, the Lord God, remember that in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. And the fear of God interbearing, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our deliverance from all tribulation, wrath, danger, necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Let the whole day may be perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless, let us ask of the Lord. Angel of peace, a faithful guide, a guardian of our souls and bodies, let us ask of the Lord. Pardon and remission of our sins and transgressions, all things good and profitable for our souls, and for peace in the world, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord,
that we may complete the remaining time of our life in peace and repentance, for a Christian ending to our life,
painless, blameless, peaceful, and a good defense before the awesome judgment seat of Christ. Let us
serve.
Call into remembrance our all holy immaculate, whose blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
Through the compassions of thy only begotten Son, with whom thou art blessed, together with thy all holy good and life and spirit, now and ever and unto ages.
Let us love one another, that with one accord we may confess.
Thanks and peace.
speed to thine only begotten Son and thy Holy Spirit, for all things of which we know and of which we know not, and for all the benefits bestowed upon us, both manifest and unseen. And we give thanks unto thee also for this ministry, which thou dost vouchsafe to receive at our hands, even though there stand beside thee thousands of angels and thousands of angels, the cherubim and the seraphim, six winged many eyes, so long, born of the kings, singing the triumph of him, shouting, proclaiming, and saying,
thank you.
God and Savior Jesus Christ, be with you all. Let us pray to the Lord. For the precious gifts worshipped and offered and sanctified, let us pray to the Lord.
Have mercy.
Our God and Lord of mankind, receiving them upon his holy heaven and ideal altar for an odor of spiritual fragrance, will send them upon us and return his divine grace. And the gift of the Holy Spirit, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Asking for the unity of the faith and the communion of the Holy Spirit, let us commend ourselves and each other and our whole life unto you, Christ our God.
Glory of God the Father.
we've served this morning can only be served to chrismated members of the Eastern Orthodox Church who have properly prepared themselves. Although if you are not yet Orthodox, we do have some blessed bread, which is not a sacrament, that we serve at the end of the liturgy, and you are certainly welcome to partake of that. With the fear of God, with faith and love, draw near. God, save thy people and bless thine inheritance.
Bless, O Lord, this new fruit of the vine.
which thou hast graciously been pleased to permit to come to maturity through salubrious seasons and gentle rains and favorable weather. Let it be also unto joy for those of us who shall partake of this offspring of the vine, and may we offer it as a gift unto thee, unto the purification of our sins through the sacred and holy body of thy Christ, with whom thou art blessed, together with that all-holy good and life-giving Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Salvation, Christ our true God, through the intercessions of his own immaculate and of blameless Holy Mother, by the might of the precious and life-giving cross, by the protection of the honorable bodiless powers of heaven, at the supplication of the honorable glorious prophet, forerunner, and Baptist John, of the holy, glorious, and all honorable apostles, of our Father among the saints, John Chrysostom, Archbishop of Constantinople, the divine liturgy we have now celebrated, of the holy, glorious, and victorious martyrs, of our venerable and God-bearing fathers, of St. Barnabas, the patron protector of this holy community, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, and of all the saints, have mercy on us and save us, for as much as he is good and loves mankind. Through the prayers of our Holy Father, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us and save us. Amen. Good morning. Blessed feast. Together we'll all enjoy these well-watered and well-developed grapes, the fruit of the vine, what God has given us to remember him, and the transfiguration that takes place in all of us the following we come to him. We're thankful this morning for the lovely visit and the words from our good friend Father Martin Vinci, and we wish him the best as he goes next to Indonesia to work on mission work there. As very important, a lot of people, as he's mentioned, a lot of people. So if you'd like to sign up before he leaves to help in Indonesia, please, I'm sure he'll take your signature. Following the veneration of the cross, we will have fellowship, a chance to meet each other, share some grapes in the fellowship hall. And I want to mention as well that this coming week, now we switch gears a bit and return to our prayers for the Dormition Mass. Monday night and Wednesday night of this week, we will pray the prayers of the miraculous service. And if you have yet to submit names for us to pray of your loved ones, please do so. Do so this morning. Fill out a sheet of paper, first name is all we need, and leave it on the front or bring it on this Monday night. There will be no service in North County this week, but we'll all be here praying together.
during this most lovely and beautiful Mass. Armin, do you have anything you must say?
Yeah, today is the last day to submit nominations for parish council, and the clock runs down at midnight.
Is that it? Blessed peace.
Oh, it sounds so wonderful. Son and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Yes. the meeting.
Something we desire and so shall be.
After we do that,
the good things and the worst days of our lives.
Questions, yes, Mr. Martin, or someone.